She looks familiar. It's that Keeper Translator girl. But that can't be. This portrait must be as old as the building.
I can hear you breathing. Nobody here in the cradle does that anymore. How did you get in? My name is Laurel. Something changed when you saw my picture. That's why you can hear me now. I want to leave here, but I can't. The cradle won't let any of us go. Will you help me? They filled up a bottle with my blood. It's down in the storm cellar. It's very dark down there. Please find the bottle and drop it into a drain pipe so it will end up outside. It's important.
This one must be hers. It's still warm. Great.
That's good. The bottle is outside now, where the cradle can't see it. I have to get rid of all my things. The cradle uses them to remember me. That's how it keeps me here. There's a ward here called Whitehall, where they kept the very bad patients. One of them took my nightgown back to his cell. It's still there. Please get my nightgown, and then burn it up in the morgue.
Some amateur work.
The staff blamed him for what happened to me. They were wrong. You did it! My nightgown's gone. Remembers more than I thought. You can't get it all here. You have to go into the past, into the cradle's memories. It's the only way. You'll have to pretend to be one of the patients so the cradle won't see you. Each of the patients from Whitehall had a favorite toy that they liked. You can use them as keys to go into the cradle's memories. Find one of those toys, and I'll tell you what to do next. used to play that when she danced for us in the old puppet theater. It's the lobotomy room now. The toy you just picked up is a key to the cradle's memories. Now you have to figure out where to bring it. There's a special place for each toy. When you put the toy in the right place, you'll enter the past. All wrapped up in wet bandages. He heard me come in and started making screaming noises. I think he wanted me to help him, but I was too afraid. It's like a stitch in time. You can't die here because you're inside a patient. But if the staff catch you, they'll take away your toy and you'll have to find another one. Now, will you get my diary? In the real world, it's all torn apart and we never find all the pages. But in the past, it's just the way I left it, up in the nursery tower. Please find it and burn it in the morgue. When they started letting the patients stay here, there wasn't enough room for everybody. All of us children had to move here into the nursery tower, where the babies used to be. playing hide and seek with my friend Drept, but he never found me. Instead, the Grey Lady found me. I tried to run, but the door was locked, and I couldn't get it open. Good. The cradle can barely remember me anymore. But it can still see the bloodstain in the attic. You'll need to clean it up in the past, where it's always fresh. Sometimes when the staff took patients to a treatment room, they wouldn't ever come back. They used something called dissolution serum to clean up afterward. Get it, and then use it on my bloodstain in the attic. Where I saw you the first time. Did it! The cradle can't remember me anymore. We can leave now. Meet me in the lobby. I'll show you the way out. Remembers you now. You've been here too long. There's only one way to leave the cradle. You have to trick it. I'll help you. First, you have to enter the past as your real self. There's a cage in the storm cellar. You have to go inside it and close the door. Then you'll enter the cradle's memories as your real self. But you can't let the staff find you. If they catch you this time, you'll be dead forever. this is a different time. Just before the end. You look like yourself now, and the cradle can see you. If the staff find you, they'll kill you. There's one last thing you have to do. Go to the top of the staff tower. There's an open window up there. You have to jump out. Then the cradle will think you killed yourself. But you won't really die. You'll just be outside where it can't see you. I'll be waiting for you. The staff tower. Nobody is allowed up there.
I finally managed to escape from that place, but I think I'm out of my depth here. I saw an old portrait of a girl who looks just like that keeper translator. But how can that be? I only found traces of the hag. I don't think she's been there since Drep saw her all those years ago. So I'm left with questions, and the vial of blood the ghost had me steal. The ghost is beckoning. I think I'd better follow. This isn't over yet.